Alright, we started our borough uprising because we did all the stuff in this borough. Islington and Hackney. So that opened up this mission here, which we'll track. Fight or flight plan. Got it. So it's Albion. Looks like we'll probably want to be Albion to infiltrate that. And that is how far away? It's fairly close. I think we'll just grab a car and head over there. I could collect some of this stuff nearby. Yeah, this stuff must be right on the border. Welcome back! Hey, thank you for the follows on the YouTubes and the Twitters and all that stuff earlier, and thank you for the support. You are here with my buddy, my longtime buddy Siege, who is he's not sure if he's that into this Watch Dogs Legion. And knowing that you just got into it yourself, maybe you guys could discuss what you like, what you don't like about it, or if you have any questions for me, let me know. Happy to answer. We are about to do a borough uprising mission, which sounds pretty fun. I'm thinking I'm going to steal this sexy looking car here. Sorry, my dude. You're not going to like DedSec after this, probably, but, you know. I'll make it up to you later.
Are missions critical?
No, not really. I mean, that's how you beat the game and the story, but you don't have to do all the side missions and stuff. I do them just for the fun and the side lore, and it just gives me more to do in the game. In fact, I try to do all the side missions I can before continuing the story. That's just how the completionist in me plays, but you definitely don't have to play like that. As you can see, I've been kind of just working my way down the side story missions path and ignoring these main stories. Sometimes you have to do some of the main stories for more of the side stories to open up, so that's just what I'll do. When I run out of side stuff to do, I'll continue on with the main missions. But we just unlocked a borough mission for... If you zoom out on your map all the way, you can see your progress in the boroughs. So this one, I need to hack the CTOS hub, it says on the side there, in order to unlock the borough uprising mission for that. I just got this bar all the way across. You see a little green bar underneath the name there, where it's only partway filled right here. So I did all the three things on the side there to unlock the borough uprising mission in that. And if I beat that, I get a football hooligan as a skilled operative for free. I don't have to recruit him or anything. And I get all the tech point locations revealed. So it really helps. You want to get tech points so that, like, you see I have 45 tech points here. So you can unlock these gadgets. And these go for all of your operatives that you recruit. They all have access to whatever you open up here. So I just fully upgraded combat spider bots. Now I can use that. So I may use that with my next dude. The borough uprising missions are really fun. They're some of the coolest missions in the game, and they give you a free operative.
What was your favorite Watch Dogs game so far?
I mean, like I was telling you before, I like them all, each for different reasons. But if I had to pick one, I probably had the most fun in Watch Dogs 1. Doing the online hacking missions. And this is coming from a person who normally does not like online play with people. I like single player story games. I don't do a lot of online.
I can respect that.
Especially PvP. PvP I don't normally do, but that's the cool thing about Watch Dogs 1. It opened me up to that. Like, after I beat the game, I turned on that mode, and people would just start hacking me in my game, and I was like, what is this all about? I have to go, like, play hide-and-go-seek and find somebody? And I just got addicted to it just by turning that option on. And then I went to start hacking people back because it would offer you the option to revenge hack them, basically, if they hacked you. And I just got really good at that and had a lot of fun. And it opened me up to playing online. And I liked Watch Dogs for that. Watch Dogs 1 for that. So that's why I kind of leaned towards Watch Dogs 1. Watch Dogs 2 does have online hacking. It's a little different with drones and things like that. And I did have a lot of fun doing that. But I'll never forget Watch Dogs 1 for opening me up to some online play. The online play in this, I haven't played a lot of. But I do want to get into it more after I beat the main game. Yeah, it is fun in Watch Dogs 2 as well. Alright, I think I want to switch to my Albion dude for this. And this is the cool thing about this game, is you have a whole team of people now. I can just swap operatives to somebody who has Albion access.
Always.
I love how they have different voices and different sayings. So, with this mission, DedSec operatives, Hanky, causing influence of Burrow's plummet, signs of underground. DedSec was contracted with someone in the grassroots, meet the informant. So we just meet an informant. Probably. I'm going to go to my team here and... Oh, okay, he's already got cloaking. So I'm going to go with cloaking. I'm going to go ahead and switch my outfit to my Albion outfit so I blend in, hopefully. Still got the cool sunglasses on there. I like that. I'm going to hit the shop here, actually. I just noticed that. So go to shops anytime you notice them. And, like, just buy something that looks cool. That way it opens up the shop in your office. Or it adds it to the shops that you have access to in DedSec.
And mainly makes you use stealth to your advantage.
It says that shop inventory has been added. Yeah, I love stealth in this game. So I'm going to switch back to my Albion outfit again. That way this guy won't, like, notice me right away. And we just gotta go talk to an informant over here. Something the matter,
officer. So, I hear you've been trying to reach DedSec.
Oh, there you are, dear. It's just lovely what you've done for the neighborhood. Those Albion thugs were becoming a bloody nuisance. Of course, now they've got their dander up. They're looking to strike back against the borough.
What do you mean?
A group of us have taken the initiative to help the community. And given the current environment, we've had to do it quietly, you understand? Under Albion noses.
Sounds like you've been doing DedSec work.
Let's just say you inspired us and leave it at that. But now,
this lady's crazy.
Albion are planning a series of raids in Hackney. We can't survive that.
And take a screenshot of her.
If you can intercept them before they strike, we'll have time to move our operation somewhere safer. I've got my hands on a little device that will allow you to zip around the borough quick as you please. Be a dear and handle this for me, would you?
Copy that.
That voice does not fit that lady at all. That's one of the problems with this game. And we've suggested to the devs that...
Right back, I'm going to try to see if I can get your stream up on my TV.
Oh, cool. No problem. So yeah, we've suggested to the devs that they've added character customization now, so you can change their hair and piercings and tattoos and facial hair and stuff like that. Why don't they add voice changers? That would be like, that would turn one of your characters you think has a crappy voice. They could add a voice box mod to themselves and change their voice. And that would make them so much better. Just give us some more access to that or give us some options. Ah, nice. So that would be awesome if they add that in the future for character customization is voice mods. Be able to change your... Oh, you can hack these things and get money? Cool. I actually wanted to play it, but I guess you can't play it. It just happened. Hijack the modified chase drone. Alright. Oh, there's a mask up top. We should go get that really quick. And there's a pasta. Alright. Hey, you're back. Yeah, I was just saying, Ubisoft offers all this new character customization where you can change their facial hair and all that kind of stuff. But a lot of characters' voices just don't match them at all, or you might want to change their voice. And they don't give you an option for that. So we were suggesting to the devs that you'd be able to change a character's voice with like a voice mod. I think it would, yeah. Alright, I want to get to this paste up and I want to find this mask.
I think that's a good idea too.
Ooh. Look at that dodge. The combat in this game is definitely better. You have the options to dodge and grab and things like that and finish. And then different characters have different weapons that can help in melee combat and stuff. So I do appreciate the improved combat in this game. Alright, so the mask it says is up. So we need a way to get higher. Which might involve a drone or something else.
Are you able to buy a house in this game?
You're not able to buy houses. You do have DedSec headquarters, but it's not like GTA. It's not about headquarter customization and all that kind of thing. It's just a different game than GTA, so do not expect that kind of thing. You can't customize cars or anything like that, really. I need to get up there somehow. The cars you get are either some characters come with vehicles as an ability. Ah, that's cool. GTA is a fun game. Oh, why did I take off my Albion outfit? Eh, whatever. But yeah, it's just a different game than GTA. We might need a drone.
This is a detail. I'm not crazy.
You're crazy. Alright. I don't see a way to climb up any higher. Maybe here. Ooh, that almost worked. Oh, I wonder if I can climb up from there. Hey, look at that. We figured out a way to climb up. It says the mask is still higher. Oh, there's the pay step, though. We can go do that.
Big brain.
Very nice. That's certainly a statement, isn't it?
Alright, you guys pick which one. No, this is 1, 2, and it just counts from there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we'll give you a 7 and 8. 7, 8. My wife likes 2. We just did 2 actually.
Oh, you
for
did
somebody.
Oh, never mind then.
But we can do it again. But
no.
I wanted the audience to pick.
Pick something different.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Which one of those 8 would you guys like, or would you guys like a different set?
I like 1, but it's your choice.
We'll go with 1. Thank you for the suggestion. This is just kind of neat. You would do this kind of thing in Watch Dogs 2, but in this part, it's actually part of the borough uprising. You're putting out a message for the rest of the borough saying, hey, DedSec is taking over. You should join us. So that's pretty neat. So the mask is up even higher. I wonder if we can get up higher. You gotta pay attention to these symbols. Don't see the mask. Now it says it's lower. And we're near it. So where is this mask hiding? Let's go ahead and grab this drone. See if we can scope it out. There's darts down there. Oh, there it is. Ah, it definitely looks like you need a spider bot to get to it. Don't have a spider bot currently. I don't see a way of getting that without a spider bot, unfortunately. So, let's see if it'll let me switch to a spider bot. It will, because I'm not inside the red zone or secure area. So let's go and slap down our spider bot. Run our little spider bot down here. And there we go, we just unlocked a mask called White People or something. Anyway. Now we can just recall our spider bot by holding R1, and we're good to go. Alright, we got all of that. There's an audio log here we can go find as well. Don't really see that in the symbols. That's cool, we figured out a way of climbing up on our own. We could have used this and called a cargo drone and had it flown us up here, but I kind of like figuring out how to climb. That was a big thing in Watch Dogs 1, was figuring out how to climb up stuff. So if you do come here, well, all we did was climb up this thing, and then you could actually turn around and gap climb up to the roof that way, which is pretty spiffy. Pretty spiffy, if you ask me. Speaking of roofs, ouch, that was a pretty hard fall. We need to figure out how to get up to this other roof. Around, we could just take a cargo drone out. Looks like we might have... Oh, there's a lift. Right, yeah. So the cool thing about these, you can do this in Watch Dogs 2 as well. If you hold the hack button, you can just control it while you're walking around. You don't have to hijack it to hack it, so it's called quick hacking. You can still look around, use your camera while you're quick hacking it, or if you go in here and just hack it, you can't move your character because he's actually controlling it through his phone now, but you can drive the whole thing. So quick hacking only lets you make it go up and down, but you can still move your character, or you can fully hack it and move it around and shit. Well, there's the audio log. Let's pick that up first.
Please, don't.
Oral history trophy.
I didn't mean to.
Where are you taking him? Stop, Jonah!
Back off, you fucking cow.
No, don't.
We saw you with those machines. Didn't crank shit and you hit jackpot each time. Think we're daft? You're fucking DedSec, aren't you?
DedSec? No, I swear. It was just a small hack.
Small hack? Who the hell did that take me for? You know what we do to DedSec members?
Just relax.
We make an example out of them.
No, no,
I like it.
No. Are you trying to get big on Twitch?
Oh no, I really stream just for the hobby of it and the community. I've been streaming since like 2014, 2015, when Watch Dogs first came out. And yeah, really it's just was about awareness of the different games communities that I play and are involved with. But I definitely appreciate it. I mean, the more word we get out there, the more community we get, right? So that's cool. That's all I really care about. I don't care about fame or fortune. I already live a pretty good life. I'm pretty happy. But I appreciate you asking. One thing I want to point out here, you notice how a lot of these laptops and screens are transparent? That is an emerging technology they have for monitors and TVs coming out now. I just love how Ubisoft looks at that kind of stuff, like emerging technologies, and then they put that kind of stuff in their game. I have to say that's a good little thing. You see how you can see the candle through the monitor there? And you'll see a lot of screens like that throughout this game where you can see through both sides. That is actual technology that's available now. Yeah, it's pretty cool. I like that they pay attention to that. And then they'll take that to the next level a lot of times. Like a lot of the things in this game, like the drone hacking and all that stuff, is all just taken to the next level. Oh, wow. What are we doing? Destroy 5 Albion raid vehicles. You take them down. Okay, see, this is a cool mission.
Slightly faster with better armor, but its maximum altitude is restricted. Also, Albion is using CDOS to monitor the borough. They could shut it down if you fly too high. Time to buzz the streets.
Okay, I think we're going for this orange thing. I don't really know. Nope, too far. Okay, I don't know what we're trying to destroy here then. Are we trying to blow up vehicles? What's it say? Destroy Albion raid vehicles. Okay, show me where an Albion raid vehicle is and I'll destroy it. Time to intercept next team. Oh. Okay, this is telling me that I'm running out of time.
Those activists are done for. Best if you just whistle casually and stroll away. The less anyone knows we have to do with this, the better.
Okay, I did not get that mission at all because it didn't mark what I was destroying. At least I didn't see that it did. Just kind of threw me into it, not knowing what to do. Very cool, hon. What's her name?
Demeter.
That's it.
Yeah, I had to look it up.
Alright, I wonder if I can start that mission again here. Alright, you guys let me know if it notifies me on the map anywhere or something what I'm supposed to be destroying.
Right then, there's no time to chit-chat. Albion have synchronized their raid teams. I'll feed you the locations as I get them. You take them down. Well, go on, you're wasting time.
This drone has been modified, slightly faster with better armor, but its maximum altitude is restricted. Also, Albion is using CDOS to monitor the borough. They could shut it down if you fly too high. Time to buzz the streets.
Is that a raid vehicle?
Inbound detected strange drone activity near your location. Over.
Pursuing the target. Over.
Is the yellow dot it? Or is that something else?
I think yellow dot's a mission, but I tried going towards it before, and it did this kind of thing. I don't know, we'll keep going.
All units, disengage. Suspect has disappeared.
Well, you're out of time. Those activists are done for. Best if you just whistle casually and stroll away. The less anyone knows we have to do with this, the better.
Put it on the phone.
Oh wow, that's weird.
Oh, I can switch audio, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was asking.
Hold on. My wife, there's fireworks going off and yeah, our dog does not like it. Dog. So I need to switch audio so that the TV... No, it's not really music.
It's just anything's better than nothing.
You guys might hear some echoing from the music. But I think my mic's pretty good at canceling it, hopefully. Alright, we'll try...
It's a war zone
with
fireworks. Yeah, well, I thought they were going
to
skip tonight, but I guess people went out and bought their extra
fireworks. Yeah, they get sales on fireworks
today. There's no time to chit-chat. Albion have synchronized their raid teams. I'll feed you the locations as I get them. You take them down. Well, go on. You're wasting time.
This drone has been modified. Slightly faster with better armor, but its maximum altitude is restricted. Also, Albion is using CDOS to monitor the borough. They could shut it down if you fly too high. Time to buzz the streets.
Alright, I'm going straight towards the marker. And... oh, here's one. You're right. Okay.
That looks like a bloody good time. But don't dilly-dally. Off to the next one before they launch their raid.
Look sharp. You've got Albion drones heading your way.
Alright. It was the markers. I thought those were, like, other mission markers. We want to avoid getting destroyed. That'll give you a lot of time. Oh shit. Sorry, I was paying attention to the mini map.
Well done, but no time to waste. Head to the next location.
Alright. I guess they do give you extra time for some. Oh, that's good. Ah! Oh shit, we're limited height. I think I just stuck myself. Yep, I can't go up higher. I got trapped. They gave us on a height limit, they even pulled me out. This is as high as we can go. Drone parties in here, but you only want to use two more. You can do it. I have to remember that one. That approach was not the best approach for that. There was too much heat around it. Alright, at least we have an idea what we need to do now. These missions are cool because they're like totally different all the time. My favorite one was taking a spider bot through these platforming challenges, climbing inside Big Ben. That was my favorite one so far. This one's probably not my favorite one. But it's kind of neat that they were able to do something.
This drone has been modified, slightly faster with better armor, but its maximum altitude is restricted. Also, Albion is using CDOS to monitor the borough. They could shut it down if you fly too high. Time to buzz the streets.
How do you like the PS5?
We love the PS5. I waited on I was gonna get a PS4 Pro. But I was like, I might as well wait for a PS5. And the PS5, right now, there's not a huge amount of actual PS5 games. But it's better than a PS4 Pro. Like, it's like a PS4 Pro Pro. Not only do I get all the advantages of playing the games that I already own or want to play that I would have played on a PS4 Pro, I get to play them with super fast loading times as well.
Well done, but no time to wait. Head to the next location.
What is the follow-up? I don't know if I want to shortcut it, please. Damn it. It's like an obstacle course.
I'm trying to get one, but I can't find any.
Oh, my wife got really lucky. We got it on, like, the first night they went on sale. She spent 4.5 hours online,
and she just happened to, a friend of hers told her they just got one, like, at 3 a.m. In the middle of the night, and they had just reset their website, so a bunch just became available. So yeah, we wouldn't have one if my wife was determined.
I was at Walmart trying to get one, and I saw two moms puking each other over the PS5.
Wow. I we sort of know where this one is. Somewhere down here. Really well guarded. Hopefully we can get this last one this time, because that the fourth one was 50. Yeah. Yeah, this looks far away. Yay, we did it, finally. 8 times the charm, or some shit like that.
Nice job.
Thank you. Thank you for the help, guys, because that's what another reason why I love streaming, is people on the stream can see things that I might have missed and give me tips and help me out. I wouldn't have got that without you guys. I appreciate it. Islington and Hackney. Hackney. Sorry. Yeah, I think my wife wants me to make a Taco Bell run. I put the idea in her head. She just got finished playing a D&D session with her friends online. So she hungry, I'm hungry. This lady is not making me hungry, but that's okay. Hard pass. My wife thinks.
Albion doesn't stand a chance if we're fighting together.
Well, our barista at Starbucks the other day had all red hair like this. Not in a mohawk, but they had red
eyebrows
and red contacts in their eyes, too.
Sounds like Hackney and Islington are ready to rise up and defy Albion. Couldn't ask for a better result, DedSec.
Yeah. Oh, they had like almost like a wrench mask.
Yeah, they had like a wrench mask and a money fast. All these metal products.
All right, we're gonna swap to the new recruit we got just to check him out real quick, and then I'm gonna call it a night. But yeah, I posted a picture on the Watchdogs Discord of the barista. Yeah, a couple people saw the wrench. How it looks like wrench too, and liked it. I like that when you switch characters too. Your current character like talks to your new character. Who's fighting? Why are people fighting? What the fuck? Oh, they're fighting. Oh, they're. See, now the borough uprising, they actually took out an Albion guard on their own. That's pretty cool. And then I can hide it for them. I hid the body. Alright, so this is our new recruit. Let's see what they do. Alright, they have rally cry so they can call friends to fight. They're tough drunk, so they take less damage, and they do fast knockouts. Nice. They're a football hooligan. Look, she's got the face, too, like football hooligan. That's pretty cool. So you unlock some cool operatives, and then now that we made this area defiant, I'm going to zoom out here. We only have one more to go, which is the center of city of London, which is the one I kind of wanted to save last anyway. It's at the center of the map. But now that we've opened that up, it shows you all the locations of the tech points that you're missing and other things in the area, like relics, audio logs. So if you are a completionist or collector or want to unlock all the abilities and stuff or get lots of money from the cryptocurrency ETO. You can all see it now in that area because we have made this borough defiant, which is very much like actually Assassin's Creed Syndicate, which took place in London as well. If you ever play that game, you could do somewhat like borough uprisings, and basically turn that borough over to your gang as opposed to the whatever gang ran that borough against you. It's almost like DedSec, but like the precursor to it, you know? Just not a hacking group, but more like actual gang, because they didn't have hacking back then. They had horses and carriage. But I like that they took some of those, that stuff from Syndicate, and because it takes place in London too, put a new spin on it for DedSec and Watch Dogs in London. Worked out rather well, I think. And I was playing through Syndicate, even though I'm not a huge Assassin's Creed fan, just to learn the London map. And it's a smaller section, like it only goes about the inner parts of this map. Like, you drew like a circle around the center of it and left. They just added a bunch to the outside, basically. You have Camden, which isn't part of Syndicate's, Nine Elms, some lower Lambeth. Southwark was, most of it anyway, and you had some of Westminster, but not all that you have here. And then you didn't have, actually the map ended here in the normal game. It only went down the Thames this far. The Tower of London and the Tower Bridge isn't in the normal map of Syndicate. It is in a side DLC mission called World War II. As an add-on, just this section here, which was actually pretty fun. That's about as far as I got in that before Watch Dogs Legion came out, and now I get this whole big map of London. But it was definitely kind of fun to learn London by playing through Syndicate a bit. I may go back and actually finish it at some point. But thank you all for stopping by. Thank you all for the cool support tonight. And, definitely going to be playing some Aiden DLC. Hopefully I'll have time tomorrow. If not tomorrow, definitely sometime later this week. So I'm looking forward to playing the Bloodline DLC with Aiden and Wrench. So, old man Aiden with the graggly beard. So that should be super fun. I'm going to go get some tacos for you, man. We're going to eat them up. What'd you have for dinner before I go? You said you had to stop for dinner earlier. What'd you end up eating? Just curious. We love food over here, so. Love the content. Keep up the good work. Thank you, my friend. Thank you.
Texas Roadhouse.
My wife loves Texas Roadhouse.
I like the food, but hate the noise.
Yeah, she likes the food, but hates the noise. But awesome steaks, man. Awesome food there. But yeah, enjoy. Thank you for stopping by. It is loud in there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's dance for this guy. Just for some banging music playing. Oh, he likes it. Yeah, we could recruit this guy, but he comes with a vehicle. The body piercer, and he has, that's pretty nice actually, but I need somebody with a couple more perks than just two. Although some people I get for their look, he's got a cool look. Yeah, that's cool. Alright, we're dancing out the stream, y'all. See y'all later.
Bye, see you later.